Well, Ed from Pegasus Electrical is just making those final connections to liven up our Schneider Acti 9 isobar P distribution board. I thought I'd jump in and do the external earth fault loop impedance of a three-phase supply. Now, this might be something that's very useful for people doing AM2, AM2S or AM2E. And also, Ed's got a slightly different MET, main earthing terminal. So we get a chance to have a look at that as well. So we can do some testing with Ed. If this is going to help with AM2, obviously we're going to have a look at the arrangement we've got here. We're going to carry out that external earth fault loop impedance test, but we've actually got the main switch here, four pole switch for our three phase distribution board. But in our system, we've also got an external isolating switch where we're going to carry out our test. If for some reason you don't have one of these at your AM2, AM2S or AM2E assessment, everything we do down here would actually be carried out at the bottom of this switch here, which you can see is in the off position. For your AM2, obviously we're gonna have to isolate the distribution board before starting the test, and we're gonna do it from the bottom of the switch, or in our case, from this switch over here. Because we're gonna remove the earthing conductor, obviously the installation will have no connection to earth, therefore ADS wouldn't be in place. So all of the devices within the distribution board have been isolated. We've isolated down here, and it could be that the bottom of the switch is live for testing purposes, but on ours, we're gonna test it down here in order we can carry out that external fault loop impedance test. So that's the first maybe subtle difference between yours and your AM2 rig. And the other thing I wanna show you down here is our main earthing terminal, which you're likely to have at your AM2, but we're gonna disconnect it in a slightly different way. So I'm gonna bring Eddie and we'll talk about removing those parallel earth paths. Can you just set your instrument up for us and then we'll go through the test and we'll talk through what we're gonna be doing, Eddie. So what are you gonna set it to for me?
I will set it to the Z.
For what?
That's for the impedance.
Okay, so we're carrying out a live test. We're measuring the external impedance offered by the supply authority's cable feeding the installation. This earthing arrangement, can you just remind me what it is?
This is a TNCS.
And what's the maximum ZE available for a TNCS?
0.35
of an ohm. That's right, so we'd expect this reading to be considerably less than that,
of course,
but that is the maximum. However, we've got all these parallel earth paths here. One of these green and yellow conductors coming out and up is actually for the board itself, so that's the earthing conductor coming in just there. The other one, however, goes off to something else. What does that go off to?
That goes off to the structural steel of the building,
which is buried to the greater mass of earth. So that becomes a parallel earth path. So all parallel earth paths need to be removed. On AM2, AM2S and AM2E, that might be the case that you've got a couple of green and yellow conductors going off to maybe the gas and water. So in order to remove those parallel earth paths, we normally just take out the conductor which is there, which is our earthing conductor, from the MET. But with this system, we don't have to, do we? What are we going to do in order to remove that parallel path?
On this system, Gary, we've got a link which we can remove.
Okay, so when we take that out, effectively the installation has no connection to earth. Well, we've turned everything off up there. And we've removed the parallel earth path, in this case created by the structural steelwork, because there is no bonding to water here because it's got a plastic incoming water pipe. So that's now got the external earth source. We could connect to there and the bottom of our switch in order to do the test, and that's probably what you might do on AM2, AM2S and AM2E. But we're going to connect between our disconnected earthing conductor and our lines. Of the three readings we get now, Eddie, which one will we record?
We'll be recording the highest one, Gary.
Okay, so you're going to probe on in the safest possible manner, so I take it we're going to clip onto our earthing conductor first.
Yep.
We're currently off because obviously the isolating switch is off. So earthing conductor. And then our machine needs to be turned on.
Yes, on this meter we go to LPE first for the live to earth.
So that's line to protective earth, and you're going to measure between L1 first?
Yes, we will be, yeah.
Okay, so L1.
Need to have it on.
Well, we knew it was off, so that's good. So we've got a voltage. You've got it set to 3 lead low.
Oh yes, we have here.
Okay, so there's your first one. So we're gonna connect it to, you're gonna go 2 lead high. Yep, the reason we can do a high test is because there is no RCDs, is there?
No.
Okay, so again, I don't know on your AM2, AM2S and AM2E rig whether there is an RCD, but your instructor will tell you. So we're 2 lead high. Right, so that's considerably less than the maximum. Just remind me what the maximum was.
0.35.
So that says finish the test, agreed?
Yes.
Or have we got to do the other two lines?
We've got to do the other two lines now.
Okay, so we can't just take that first reading. We've got to do all three. So this is L2. Okay, and of all the readings you get, which one will you record, Eddie?
We'll be recording the highest one.
Okay. I know some people record all three, but the paperwork will require the highest one to be recorded. So is that the highest one?
That's the lowest one. Okay, so it's the 0.22 we'll be recording for this.
So that's the external earth fault loop impedance, the ZE of the installation, agreed?
That's correct, yeah.
So it's not a ZE test, it's the external earth fault loop impedance that we just measured. We know the earthing arrangement is TNCS, and we know the maximum was 0.35, and we got it under the maximum. We're going to record the highest of the three readings that we got. Are you happy with that test?
Yes.